But we've always been on the opposite sides of things, and I've been trained to think that you are the devil. I don't know if Eric remembers the only time that we've actually spoken up until now.
I absolutely do not.
Super Brawl 1993, Asheville, North Carolina.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Super Brawl 3.
I was there.
I had made a deal with Cowboy Bill Watts to work together with WCW and Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We brought the Rock and Roll Express and the Heavenly Bodies down to do a shoot angle on TBS television, where I had cleared with Bill Watts all these horrible things I was going to say about the previous administration, thus making people believe that we were really doing something that was against the grain, so to speak. And it was edited when it was aired on television. And I had still had a few little birds in WCW, and I asked, why were all those shoot comments edited out? And they fingered you and another person. So instantly, you were painted
were
as popular as
Crotch
Rock.
Were you in charge at this point?
No, I wasn't.
See, that's what I'm finding ironic.
But see, that's part
smile
two.
On my face.
That's what I was told. But then the second time that we saw each other, you didn't speak to me and I didn't speak to you because it was 2 years later when I gave Bryant Anderson, Ole Anderson's son, a job in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And I said, I want to come to Atlanta, Ole. Will you do some promos for your boy? And he said, yeah. He said, come to the power plant. I said, you want me to come there? And he said, yeah. So we're shooting interviews out in the parking lot. 30 minutes later, in comes Eric. Boom. You looked at me.
What was I driving?
You were driving a Corvette.
Black?
I believe it was.
It was a sweet car.
It was a nice car. While you were in the power plant, I picked my nose and put a booger on the windshield.
That's such a loving gesture.
Well, I try.
You owe him for that.
You looked at me and you looked at Bryant and you said, Ole, I want to talk to you. And you guys went inside. Then you came back out, looked at me, got in the car, took off. Then you got on the phone the next day and fired him. But since then, we've always been on a different side.
Let's clear a few things up.
Okay.
That's all right with you, Michael?
Yeah.
Give me your comeback.
Because, and it's not so much a comeback, but I have to say that so much of your perception of me and what I did back when you thought I did it is kind of BS. I wasn't in control back during the Bill Watts transition.
Well, you were trying to be.
No, I wasn't trying to be. You have such a misinformed perspective of what was really going on because you weren't there. And as you say, you were relying on stooges to kind of give you the information, and your stooges were telling you things that they probably thought you wanted to hear. That's the nature of stooges.
But why didn't you deny it to me then when I asked you about it?
Didn't feel the need to.